In this session, we would like to show you how to apply Econometric Modeler app in MATLAB Econometrics Toolbox to process time series. The first step is to start the app. To launch the app, you can either run the command Econometric Modeler or simply click the button Econometric Modeler under the Apps tab. If they don't work, you need to check if you've installed Econometrics Toolbox or you need to upgrade it to the latest version. As we can see in the online document of this app, we introduced this feature in MATLAB 2018-8. You need to make sure that your MATLAB version is no earlier than that and you've installed Econometrics Toolbox. After the app is started, it is necessary to load the data either from workspace or from a previously saved MAT file. In this example, we choose to import the existing data from workspace. After the data file is imported into the app, you can see all the time series usually saved as separate variables in time series pane. And all the time series are automatically plotted in the chart. Time series could be of very different scales. Some are in percentage, like growth rate or interest rate. Some are in billions or trillions, like GDP. When that happens, it's very hard to identify the time series of smallest scale if all data are plotted in one chart. To plot only one time series in a chart, simply double-click the variable in time series pane. If you want to plot more than one time series in the same chart, right-click your mouse on the chart, point your cursor at Show Time Series, and select the ones you want to see in the menu. You can certainly make any time series disappear by deselecting them. You can also pop up the chart in a separate window by right-clicking the mouse on the chart and selecting Export. You can further edit the chart by selecting corresponding options under the Edit menu. For example, we can change the property of axis. In the Property Inspector panel, you can increase the font size, change the spacing of axis, or add grays to the chart. After you finish editing, you can save the chart as whichever format in the options. For example, a JPG file, so that you can put it in the report or thesis later. There are other ways to examine the relation of different time series. If you want to observe the relationship of a pair of time series, you can use Control key and mouse to select two time series, for example, GDP and COE, namely the paid compensation of employees. Both time series are in billions of US dollars. Then click Plot tab and then Correlations button. This newly generated correlation matrix shows you the histograms of the two time series, respectively, on the diagonal, and the correlation of the pair of time series on the anti-diagonal with each time series in turn as x-axis and y-axis. Same as the last example, you can export this correlation matrix in a separate window and change the properties of the chart under Edit tab. After you finish editing the chart, another trick you can use is to generate code to create a function which contains codes that can repeat the previous steps you made with mouse clicks. By using this function on other time series, you can create similar charts with the same properties you just applied on the previous charts without repeating those steps of mouse clicking. Now let's go back to the Econometric Modeler tab and see what we can do further to the time series. Let's take GDP as an example. This is a time series in billions of US dollars. We usually don't use it directly in model fitting, such as in an OLS model, because such model requires the time series to be stationary. GDP contains seasonal factors and trend and is not stationary. But GDP growth rate is often applied in such model. The calculation of growth rate is not complicated, and it's even easier in the Econometric Modeler app. First, let's select GDP, then click Log button in Transforms panel. The log value of GDP is created. Then we click Difference button to view the difference of log values. The results are growth rates of GDP. That is, if you are very familiar with this app, you can quickly get the growth rate of any time series by clicking Log button and Difference button in turn. You can also rename the newly created time series. For example, we can change the name to GDP Growth. Please bear in mind that all the data in Econometric Modeler app will be lost once you close this app. We can export this time series back to MATLAB workspace if we want to keep it.